What is up, fellow bench warmers? Welcome to Courtside DFS, your daily dose of fantasy DFS. I'm your host, JJT of the Fantasy Bench Warmers, with Commish Eric.
Yes, Commish.
Hindi maganda yung araw ko today, so tingnan na ba natin?
But,
hindi, talo ko, tambak eh. No? So, well, first, tingnan muna natin yung matchup namin ni Commish, and then we'll go through tomorrow's games. Yung injuries plus the games, ano yung mga okay na games, and then we'll go through the lineups or sino yung mga pwede natin i-roster na players. Okay? Sige, pakita na natin, Commish, yung ano, lineup para makita nila kung gaano ka tambak.
Hindi naman.
53 to 305. Malaki na yan. 50 plus.
Pero, ano, balikan natin yung pinag-usapan natin kahapon. DeRozan, we were in agreement yan eh, na DeRozan.
Yeah.
Yung Cam Thomas versus Seth Curry, yun ang isang pinag-aiba natin. You went with Cam, I went with Seth. So, nag-hit naman tayo dun kay Seth, no? Si Anfernee Simons din, parehas tayo dyan. Pero ang parehas din natin, sino ba yung manloloko sa'yo?
Si Stewart, yung favorite ko, dinisappoint ako. Stewart, madami eh. Stewart, Diallo, so-so lang. Si Royce, well, you weren't high on Royce naman eh. So, hindi rin ako super high. Fill-in lang talaga. Si Ayo, so-so lang rin. Medyo mahina. Maraming so-so lang. Hindi mo masabing manloloko si Stewart eh. Kasi above pa rin the... Kasi 16 lang yata siya or 17 lang siya. So,
to wrap it up, no, ako kahapon was Butch and DeRozan. I'm satisfied with them. Ang mali ko was Kuzma. I was thinking of Randall. I should have went with Randall, which one of the top players today, 50-something points. And then si Kuminga sana hindi ko ginamit. Kasi if I used Randall, I could have used a $10 player. No? Could have performed well. And then the mga top players today was Bruce Brown.
Yan. Mitchell Robinson. Yan.
And Mitchell Robinson. Yan. Yan ang mga top.
Fournier, actually. Who would have thought, di ba? Yes. Fournier, 50 points. And of course, si Terrence.
Actually, yung OKC New York nga, actually, yung maraming gumawa. Josh Giddey. Yun yung slow pace dapat na game, pero medyo maganda yung pace nila, nag-overtime pa.
Yeah.
So, hindi rin natin masabi minsan eh. That happens. No, that happens.
Okay, so tara, tignan na natin yung tomorrow's games. We have 7 games on the slate. Sino ba?
Sa injuries. Tayo.
Yes.
Injuries.
Ita kagad, Ja Morant.
Okay, unahin na natin si Ja Morant. That's, for me, very important na injury to. Kasi, well, the last game na tweak nga niya yung ankle niya, questionable siya. But kung hindi siya maglaro versus New Orleans sa fast pace team, medyo maraming mag-open up na value dyan. So, titingnan natin si Ja Morant. And then, si Giannis did not play today. Pero, probable siya kahapon if you remember.
Yeah.
He's not gonna play today. Probably yesterday. I think, baka rest. Baka rest lang. So, baka maglaro siya. So, kailangan din nilang bantayan yan. If he plays, not bad yung matchup. Actually, hindi not bad. Good matchup. Kasi, Indiana yun eh.
Oh.
Pero ang interesting diyan guys, even yung odds ng Indiana at Milwaukee. Ibig sabihin ba hindi na maglalaro si Giannis? Yun ang titingnan nila. Kasi why is it an even odds there, 'di ba?
Oh.
So baka yun ang clue. And then si Jimmy Butler. Jimmy Butler is also questionable with a shoulder injury. And then hand in hand yan with Caleb Martin and nakasulat na dito. Tsaka si Tyler Hero who's already out. Tyler is already out for tomorrow. So, with that, if Jimmy Butler doesn't play, may mga ko-consider din tayo dyan. May nabanggit na si Jeremy. Mamaya, babanggitin niya yung player na pwedeng mag-hit dito. And then, yung mga iba, Bogdan Bogdanovic from Atlanta. He's questionable, but remember also that yung Atlanta game is a part of a back-to-back. Tomorrow and the day after that, back-to-back yun. So, baka i-rest rin nila si Bogdan for tomorrow's game. So, yan. Importante rin yan. And of course, yung sa Indiana, Isaiah Jackson is still out. Malcolm Brogdon is questionable. So, yun. Yun ang mga siguro titingnan natin.
Okay.
Yun, so, tomorrow.
So tomorrow's games, looking at tomorrow's games, dun sa 7 games, it's looking like ano bang okay na game. Charlotte pa rin ang favorite nating Charlotte. Is still one of the top teams in terms of pace. 244.
Hindi na kailangan i-memorize yan. Basta pag may Charlotte, usually good game. And nagkataon Minnesota is also a fast-paced team. So both really, really poor defensive teams. Charlotte, Minnesota is good. Memphis, New Orleans. Kakasabi lang natin, kung lalo kung di maglaro si Ja Morant, ang daming Memphis players na baka pwedeng i-consider in a game like this. Indiana, Milwaukee also actually is not bad. Especially if Giannis doesn't play. So itong tatlo, magandang matchup. Kung sabihin yung bad matchup, yung Philly game tomorrow versus Boston, which is a nationally televised game, feeling ko baka yan yung mas hindi maganda. Kasi Boston is one, Boston is a very, very strong defensive team. Sabihin ko na yung trivia ngayon pa lang para mauna na natin yung trivia natin. Boston actually owns the top defense already the past 2 weeks. So, does it affect Maxi, Embiid? Hindi natin alam. Embiid naman kasi matchup proof eh. Pero kahit pa paano, hindi siya, you know, 70 points, 80 points. We don't expect that unless this goes through into overtime, which, you know, we can't predict. Pero yan ang bad matchup for me.
James Harden din, ha? Just in case. Yeah. Hindi pa alam. No James Harden tomorrow. All right, let's talk about some yung picks natin. Top picks. Yan, Embiid.
Go muna.
Embiid. Am I worried about Boston being the top defensive team? Hindi naman. Kasi sabi mo, ha, very defense-proof. Eh. If you look at Embiid's numbers, even against the tall Cleveland lineup, naka 76.8 points siya fantasy-wise. Diba? So even with Phoenix, naka 59 points siya, almost 60 points. Which means kaya niya mag-hit at least the dollar value, close to that dollar value or above the dollar value. So medyo hindi ako worried. In fact, it might pose a challenge for him.
Pero playing a devil's advocate lang bago mo i-continue. Yeah. I think Embiid will reach 60, possible 55, 60. Kaya yan, maka 65. Pero yun nga, sinasabi natin, 54 kasi siya eh. So, mas mahirap.
Wala niya maka 70 more or less.
Oo, yun eh. Wala
para masulit 70, mo.
Para masulit mo. So, yun ang medyo worry ko. Pero yung 55 to 60, kaya niya yun. Mahihit niya yung dollar value. Pero yun ba yung pinaka best na gamit ng $54 mo, that you have to think about.
Ang babantayan ko dito, the status of Giannis, kasi if Giannis plays, baka i-switch ko sila ng dalawa.
Yeah. Yun, so yan ang yun.
Potentially gagawin ko. Else ang top players ko, if we look at the players above 30, Terry Rozier has been hitting pretty much double the dollar value for the past 2 games. Tumaas na rin yung dollar value niya, $33 from the $28 or below 30. So medyo nagmahal na rin ng konti. But given na Minnesota fast-paced game, mainit si Rozier eh. Pag mainit si Rozier, we'll ride that out to see kung anong mangyayari. And of course, si Anthony Edwards, another player on that Charlotte-Minnesota game. Siya yung napili ko among all the Minnesota players na pwede. So Anthony Edwards. Okay.
Agree ako doon kay Reggie Jackson, sorry, kay Terry Rozier sa kay Anthony Edwards na pagpilian ko rin 'yan given Charlotte Minnesota ngayong target game natin. So ang choice ko actually there, I chose Karl Anthony Towns instead of Anthony Edwards kasi we know Charlotte gives up so many points to opposing center. Na trivia na natin before 'yan. They're the number one team na nagigive up ng points opposing center and this is Karl Anthony Towns. So I'm gonna ride with him and then play him. LaMelo, of course, $42 in a game like this. I think he will hit. That might be my strategy. I won't go Embiid or Giannis. I may go with LaMelo and then Karl Anthony Towns, possibly. And then Haliburton. If I cannot play ball and Karl Anthony Towns, I'm really gonna go to Haliburton at 34. That's super cheap. Yeah, itong mas confident ako na yung value na 50 points hit na hit to. Hit na hit yung value na 50 points. So, yan ang favorite ko, si Haliburton. Kung may iba pa, let's say, babanggitin ko lang like Miles Bridges, syempre sa Charlotte game, medyo mura siya. So, another player to consider. Yun lang sa pay-up ko. Pero, okay. Ang top ko talaga is Scott, Haliburton, and LaMelo. Yeah.
Okay, so mid-range sa mid-range tayo, I had Steven Adams versus the New Orleans Pelicans. past few games have been hitting, past couple, actually 3 out of the 4 games, hitting siya. So I think should be a good play rin si Steven Adams. Sino pa? Reggie Jackson. Wala eh. Walang go-to guy ng Clippers. So anyone who's hot, and right now Reggie Jackson has been hot. At $22 lang, he's been hitting 3 straight games na. So 35, 50, and 39 points. So, tumataas rin yung assist niya. Actually, maganda if he can continue the 8-9 assist mark kasi pampadagdag yan ng fantasy points. So, yun yung ano ko, mid-range players.
Ako, yung Reggie Jackson, napili ko rin yun. Si, nabanggit mo kanina kay Lowry, eh, pinag-iisipan
mo. Yeah, Lowry.
If Jimmy doesn't play, I think Lowry, $25. Kahit Dallas, medyo mas pangit na matchup. Piling ko, kayang-kaya ma-hit yan. Bad game the last game, pero that was with Butler. Without Butler and Hero, Lowry, I like him. Clint Capela. Clint Capela, $21. Walang John Collins, we know that. Cleveland is a big team. So I don't think Atlanta can play small against them. They would need Capela. I think he will get at least 30. He already got 30 minutes the last game. I think he can get 30 minutes and he can get to 35 fantasy points finally by tomorrow. $21 lang si Capela. And then last ko dito siguro si si Kelly Oubre. Just ano, if in case lang, hindi siya magiging popular bukas, in case lang na, you know, hindi kayo nag-Lamelo, hindi kayo nag-Miles, hindi kayo nag-Rozier, gusto niyo ng exposure sa Charlotte, I think Oubre is someone to consider then. Although struggling na.
And lastly, yan, ang low-end value picks, ang favorite value pick ko actually is Terrence Mann. Who's been really hot past few games, hitting easily 6 straight games. So 5 straight games hitting 46, the highest today at 46.4 without Norm Powell for sure yan. Jalen Smith, marami baka mag-O'Shea or ano, pero wala si Isaiah Jackson. Goga, I don't think he's a threat. And he is faster, he is better. Partner with Haliburton, so baka mag-feast din siya. At $11, I think easily kaya niya naman niya mag-hit. And Grayson Allen, walang Connaughton. Like today, 25 points sa 25 fantasy points today ba or yesterday?
Today.
25 yes. Fantasy points. So pag wala rin Giannis tomorrow, could be a better way, better play pag walang Giannis kasi wala rin, kulang rin yung firepower nila.
Yes. Ako, mabilisan na natin. O'Shea Brissett, as you said, $16. Yes. Always. And then, Matt Montrezl-Harrell, $16 also. In a game na fast pace, I think kaya niya ma-hit yan. Last 2 games, alam ko na sa 30 na yan. So yeah, 33 the last game. So kaya niya ma-hit yan. Lance Stephenson and Buddy Hield, yung Indiana pair natin with Duarte out. Buddy Hield, hindi na siya nagiging scoring dependent na lang. May mga assists na rin, may mga rebounds na rin. So tumaas na yan eh. Pero still, I like that. And then finally, banggitin ko lang yung mga injury possible na values. Kevin Huerter, if Bogdan doesn't play, $15. And then De'Anthony Melton, if sakaling Ja Morant hindi maglaro, I think he's 17, so pwede mo rin i-consider yan. Yung iba kasi na banggit na ni Jeremy, I agree with Grayson, agree with Terrence Mann definitely, and then Jalen Green. So Jalen Smith, I'm sorry. So yan yung mga picks namin.
Alright, so yun, that's it for Courtside. May trivia ka ba? Or yun na yun, yung Boston?
Yun.
Top defensive team Boston for the past 2 weeks. That's the trivia for today. And that wraps up our Courtside DFS. And of course, as always, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye.